Please turn off all electronic devices. There is to be no talking or texting during the performance. If you must leave, please do so only in between musical numbers and using the back exit. Ladies and gentlemen, remove all hats and enjoy tonight's reception.
Thank you. whose piece we got to premiere at Clarinet Fest. He did an arrangement of his piece for solo pipa clarinet and solo bass clarinet with wind symphony. Dropping hints. But he arranged it for bass clarinet choir, and we got to premiere that at ICA. So that was a lot of fun. We enjoyed his works a lot. They challenge us in terms of range. You may have never heard a bass clarinet play that high. It is exciting. So if you're ever in a position where you're writing for bass clarinet, know they can do more than you think they can. We also would like to thank Alice High School and Aransas Pass High School and Rivera High School and for loaning us some instruments, because I had the wonderful problem of having more people interested in bass clarinet choir than we have instruments, and we actually had 9, so that was a fair amount for any school. But Alice High School loaned us another contrabass and another contralto so we could get some real power, and then we also have some bass clarinet. So we're very grateful for those high school partnerships, and we'll go out there and we'll help their young bass clarinets play high notes too, which their band directors might or might not regret. We shall see. So this next piece is also arranged by Jonathan Russell, originally by Henry Purcell. Thank you.
I see some former Woodwinds 1 students in the audience, so they must not be that afraid of clarinet, or they think they're getting extra credit, I don't know. So this last piece, and it'll come out as soon as they're ready, is the Egmont Overture, which is, has anyone heard it before?